Get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell. Brett Somers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Beverly Garland. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
You got him riled up pretty good there, John. Thank you very much for the warmth of your welcome and for joining us here on the Tube. Hello there, group.
Hello.
Everybody ready? We ought to say hello to the new girl on the block, Beverly Garland. We're delighted to have you. Just do everything he says.
And you're going to be all right.
Now, let's welcome our two players, Jan Crone and Olivia Lenke.
Hello there, ladies.
Olivia's a current champ. She's won one game, has $600 to her credit. And we started another game with a challenge from Jan Crone here, who didn't do too well in her half of round one, did you, Jan?
No.
But you're keeping your fingers crossed for the rest of it. Okay, ladies, we'll pick up this game in the middle of round one right after we pick up on this message for you. All right, ladies, here we go with the completion of round one. This is a question for you, Olivia. Everyone will participate since it's the first go-around for her.
All right.
Dear Abby, how can I tell when the honeymoon is over? Signed, Newlywed. Dear Newlywed, the honeymoon is over. Wait a minute, I have stopped the music. Don't play the music while I'm reading the question. It's a very long question to say. Cut the music. I'll start all over again just for that. Dear
yes.
Abby,
how can I
tell when the honeymoon is over?
Yes.
Signed, Newlywed. Dear Newlywed, the honeymoon is over when your husband comes to bed with a blank.
With a blank?
With a blank.
Thank you.
Are you ready, Beverly?
I'm ready.
Oh, atta girl. Okay, we're waiting for Nipsey.
All right.
Nipsey.
There you are.
There he goes. Now we'll go over here and get a response from Olivia Lenke. Dear Abby, you heard the whole thing. The honeymoon is over when your husband comes to bed with a...
teddy bear.
Teddy bear? She says teddy bear, folks. That's her answer. All right, Nipsey, what do you say?
Don't live your life as a nagging wife. It's better to stop and think. If you insist on wearing the pants, another woman will wear the mink.
Another woman. Another woman. You said teddy bear, no match there. All right, Brett.
I won't go into when my honeymoon was over, but when your husband comes to bed with a nightgown on.
With a nightgown on. Okay, I got the idea.
I had my teddy bear till I was about 13 years old, which gives a big tip to me. But anyway, I said a simple answer, a book.
A book. Book.
Very lovely.
Teddy bears are very big with adults. I would not feel embarrassed about that, Charles.
Right.
Okay.
And a book could help you.
What do you say
right.
there?
Well, Fillmore told me that the honeymoon would be over if he came to bed with a girl.
I would say so, yes.
Not what necessarily.
No.
It'd be just a lucky day. No, you always tell when they come to bed with a sleeping pill.
Oh, that's it.
It is all finito.
Yeah, all right, down the drain. Teddy bear is the answer. What do you say?
That's how Ellen introduces me. I want you to meet my sleeping pill. With a sandwich.
With a sandwich.
There it is. Over here again.
That's right. Okay, so we didn't get any teddy bears there. Let's go to round two. And I just push the button and watch how magically this thing happens there. All right. Jan, make a selection.
B, please.
She wants B, and this is it. Folks, everybody plays since no one matched first time around. Once a year, the Jolly Green Giant brings in two little helpers to help him pick his blank. Aren't you glad you came?
I love it.
Once a year, the Jolly Green Giant brings in two little helpers to help him pick his... Everybody's ready! So, Jan, the Jolly Green Giant brings in two little helpers to help him pick his...
Beans.
Beans, she says. Well, they're in the ad, aren't they? Let's see if it happens over here. Nipsey?
Well, bless your little pea-picking heart. Two Plessis. Peas!
Peas. Sorry. Can't match peas and beans. Brett, what do you say? Peas or
to
beans?
To help him pick his seat. No.
No. No, Brett.
No. Oh, she'll never make
it. Furthermore.
Beans. No, thank you. Beans is a good answer, but he doesn't need his help, as much help for the peas because the peas are smaller and he has to bend way down.
Oh, yeah. Okay. No beans yet, sorry to say. Beverly, what do we get from you?
Well, I'll tell you, I think beans is a great answer.
Beans is a good answer, Jan. Okay. Richard, is beans a good answer?
Certainly is, young man. He brings little devils in to pick his crops.
His crops, I see.
Pick of the crop.
I see. Pick of the crop. Yeah, that's part of the ad, isn't it?
Crop of beans, by the way.
Okay.
You know,
Betty?
This is the only show in the world where peas gets a hand. Peas.
Peas. Okay. So it's 1-0, and when we come back, all you'll need is 1 to tie, 2 to win in round 2, and we will come back right after we bring these messages to you. Okay, here we are. We're ready for you, Olivia. Are you ready for us?
I don't know.
All right, last time around, you didn't score, so everybody will play. The giraffe went to the Mayo Clinic because he had a... No help from the studio audience, if you please. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but you see, your answers may be rotten.
Charles Nussbaum is looking at me.
The giraffe went to the Mayo Clinic because he had a...
Quite lethargic,
you're right.
And
absolutely. I think we're going to send a whole upper tier to the Mayo Clinic.
Oh, would you, until January 1st?
Okay, Olivia, what do you say? Why did this giraffe go to the Mayo Clinic? He had a...
sore throat.
Sore throat is a good answer. I could use one now. Nipsey, what...
sore throat.
Sore throat. Sore throat. Okay. Brett, what do you say?
I say Nipsey Russell has to leave the building, that's what I say. I also say broken neck.
Broken neck. Oh, that poor giraffe.
Don't give us ideas.
No, okay. Look at Betty White looking
Charles.
At. She doesn't like jokes
I
about
give very
animals.
Simple, clean answers and try to dress very prettily. I said a very sore throat.
Yeah. So there's another match for you, Olivia, and I mean you're in the game. Okay, so there's another $100 for you, Olivia. And we have to say goodbye to Jan Crohn. It's been a pleasure meeting you, and thank you very much for being with us on Match Game 73. A gift for you backstage.
Thank
Jan
you.
Crohn. All right, Olivia. Here it is again.
Right.
You've seen it before?
Yes, I have.
You know what goes on here?
Yes.
You know that we polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Adam blank. And the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Which three celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Nipsey.
Nipsey, how do you fill in that blank? Adam?
Let me see. I'll go to the beginning. Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve is what he says. All right, another one?
Betty.
Betty White.
Adam 12.
Adam 12. Okay, one more, Olivia.
Richard.
Try Adam 13.
I was going to do Adam 11, but you did. Adam's apple.
Adam's apple. Okay, so that means you got Adam and Eve. One Adam 12 and Adam's apple. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own and give us. What would you like to do?
Adam 12.
Adam 12 it is, she says. Okay. That is the one we are looking for. Let's find out where it is. May we see the $100 response? Adam's apple is up there, the one that Richard gave you. Very good, Richard. All right, still looking for Adam 12. Here is the $250 response. Adam 12 it is. Congratulations. You got it. All right, now before we go on, for the big money, may we see the $500 response? Adam and Eve. Nipsey, you said it, didn't you? Okay, so you've got the $250. That means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. To collect, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It has to be an exact match. Please choose one now.
Nipsey.
Oh, Nipsey, yeah? You're the one. You're going to get ready
goodness.
To write. All right? You
All
face
right.
me if you would, Olivia. Here's the $2,500 question. You're coughing, Brett.
Yeah.
I'm the one with the sore throat. Stop
doctor
coughing.
Doctor on the second tier, please. A doctor up here.
All right. Now, here we go. Blank bone, B-O-N-E.
What?
Blank bone, B-O-N-E.
Blank bone.
Or blank bone. I'll give you both accents.
Well,
all right.
1 second. Go ahead.
He's finished. Now, Olivia, we need a response from you. How do you fill in that blank? Blank bone.
Funny bone.
Funny bone is a good answer. Okay, Nipsey, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
I probably won't have one after this, but I said neck bone.
Neck bone. What's that?
No.
The neck bone connected to
sure,
the head bone.
You get mistakes.
And you're going to get a shot in the head there. Well, Olivia, you're up to $950. You're still a champ. You're going to meet another player. Here comes that player now. Let us welcome Staff Sergeant Michael Herbert. Hello, Mike. You know, Olivia? Well, you look resplendent there, Michael Herbert. You want to tell us a little about yourself?
Well, I'm an Air Force recruiter. I work in Carson, California. I have a lovely wife of 9 months, Bonnie, who's here tonight, and that's about it.
Okay, nice to have you with us. Good luck. You know how it goes? All right, I push this button, you see, and reveal the first round, ask you to make a selection.
I'll try B.
B is what he wants. Everybody plays brand new game. Big Bertha. The striptease artist is so ugly, the men in the audience all yell, blank. You like that question.
I love it. And you answered very quickly,
yes,
too, Miss White.
First one.
Well, one
right,
stripper to another.
Yes. Quickly. Lay it in there. Oh, your light is not. Oh, that's right. There's something wrong with your light there. Let's fix Nipsey's fuse there. All right, Sergeant Herbert. Big Bertha, the striptease artist, is so ugly, the men in the audience all yell.
They all yell, put it on.
You like that answer? He says they all yell, put it on.
Yeah, Big Bertha used to go in the park and scare all the muggers out. Put it on.
Put it on. All right, Brett.
Well, I just drew on my own personal relationship with Mr. Klugman.
Yes.
And whenever I start to take it off, he says, keep it on.
Keep it on. Does that match put it on? Yeah, that does match. Okay. Okay, Charles.
Despite the energy crisis, she's got to keep it on.
Keep it on. All right, another match. You're doing okay, Sergeant. Now, Beverly, what did you say?
Everybody says, put it on.
Put it on. Are you going to join the club here?
Why, are they coming apart? Yes, they did say put it on, and they added one word.
What?
Now!
Now!
Put it on.
Okay, another one. You got to put it on so far. Let's see if Betty White keeps the string going.
Get it on!
Put it on! Okay. He done pretty good there, didn't he? All right, we're going to see how you do, but first we've got to do this, and then we'll come right back. All right, here we go. You're going to have two shots at it here, Olivia. He's got a perfect round of six matches there. All right, here we go. The mad scientist injected his wife with rabbit serum, and now he can't stop her from blanking.
You weren't a sick man. I'm kidding. I ask you to repeat Betty. That.
Okay.
I don't belong here at all.
Charles, have you finished?
You can swing that in ragtime, honey.
All right. All ready up there? Here we go. All right, Olivia, have a look at him. What do you say? Now he can't stop his wife from...
getting pregnant.
Getting pregnant, she says. Okay. Nepsy, what did you say?
No, I didn't say that because I had bad news today. The doctor told me I was sterile and my wife told me she was pregnant. Oh. Multiplying.
Multiplying, that's a match. Okay. There's one for you, Olivia. Brett?
You did say that he injected her with rabbit serum?
That's what I said.
Oh, couldn't stop her from having rabbits.
Having rabbits.
We'll both leave quiet.
All right. That's a match. That is a match. Okay, Charles.
I used a word that a bad lyricist would use. Mating.
Mating. No match there, they say. What occurred to you, Beverly?
She didn't have time to get pregnant because she was hopping.
Listen. Okay, Richard.
Well, I know it's hopping. All over, but breeding is definitely getting pregnant.
It sure is.
Breeding.
There it is. Light up the light. Is the light lit? No. Okay. It is lit.
Pregnant. All right.
Betty?
Through your nose. Oh. No, it was a very hoppy marriage. Hopping. That won't be
hopping.
Anything.
Hopping.
We match.
True.
Okay, so you picked up three there, Olivia, and now we'll go to round two, and we're going to skip him and ask you to make a selection. I am pushing the button, folks. There it is. See me pushing the button. See Gene pushing the button, and the thing finally falls down there. Okay. Thank you. There's nothing. I push my button all the time, and nothing happens. So. All right, would you make a selection? B is what she wants. Now, last time around, you matched three celebrities, Richard, Brett, and Nipsey, so three of you will not participate. Okay. This is only for Charles, Betty, and Beverly. Shirley said, "My husband is getting very peculiar. Instead of water, he soaks his false teeth in a glass of blank."
Shirley said that about her.
Shirley said that. All right. Oh, she had four. The likes got a little bit mixed up. So she only has to match who, Beverly and Betty, is that it? Okay. All right. Charles, you don't have to write, we discovered this time. But...
oh.
Yes.
But I'll sell this to anybody.
I'll just peek at it, just for old time's
sake.
And
then we can meet later and have a little.
That's right, okay. Oh, yes, dear. Okay. Oh, I think that would have been terrific there. Now, everybody's ready, so Olivia will call on you for a response. Shirley said, "My husband is getting very peculiar. Instead of water, he soaks his false teeth in a glass of..."
Booze.
Booze. Okay. Let's see. It's Beverly.
Well, I had to name it. It was Scotch.
Scotch.
Same as booze.
Is that a match?
That's a
match. That is a match.
That's booze.
Okay, Scotch is booze, and Betty White.
And vodka's booze.
So, we got a tie score. Well, you did the old rabbit trick, didn't you, Olivia? So now we've got a tie here. We'll wipe the slate clean. And we'll go to a tiebreaker. I will push the button, and again... Oh, it was this one. There you go. Thank you very much. There's a tiebreaker. We're going to take a moment here to fix a machine, and then we'll come back to you right after this. All right? Gee, I'm sorry to say we don't have time to finish this tiebreaker here. So we're going to leave you hanging in limbo there for a little while. Will you come back next time?
I sure will.
You better come back next time. Thank you very much. You're both terrific people, and so are you. How was it your first time around?
It was fun.
Will you come back again?
Could I?
And again? And again? And again?
Nipsey's picking on me.
What's he doing to you? Nipsey, will you leave that lady alone? She's okay.
Tell me to shut up.
No, I just said she should have a big hand.
A big hand?
You're right across the mouth.
Now listen, there's one thing that I wanted to point out is that Betty White, and you may not know this, you're like a semi-regular on
irregular.
What are you?
An irregular regular on
Mary Tyler Moore Show. I'm having so much fun. I'm on again the 22nd of this month.
That's this week.
This
coming week, isn't it? Or very soon.
It also means she doesn't have to go home to Alan.
Listen, it was terrific having you with us, and we hope you'll be with us next time. Join us next time for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are from Montgomery Ward's Christmas catalog. Accelerators, four-car slotless electric road race set. Plenty of fun and action for all ages from the Montgomery Ward catalog. And Papermate executive pen and pencil set featuring the Papermate PowerPoint pen that pumps ink into the points so it writes at any angle. And a supply of Swiss Miss Instant Cocoa Mix made with real miniature marshmallows and good non-fat dry milk already in it. You just add water. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.